Hi there, I'm Sarah from Great Days by Sarah, and today I'll be taking you through a yoga flow. So whether you're 6 weeks postpartum, 6 months, or 6 years, it's a great intro back into yoga. Just make sure that you have been cleared by your doctor to say that you can exercise if you've just had a baby. So today we'll start off with some warm-ups and then we are gonna go into a flow. But take it easy, listen to your body, and do what feels good for you. If at any point this does not feel good, just stop in your tracks. We'll go back and try again tomorrow. Join me on your mat. Find yourself into a comfortable seat. Legs can be straight out in front or crisscrossed in front of you. Sit up nice and tall, find a long, tall spine. Hands just gently in your lap. We're gonna start off with some neck rolls. Drop the ear to one side. Slowly roll to the center, still keeping a long spine, and then over to the other side. Back up straight through center, we won't go backwards. Same direction. And one more this way. Back up to center. Make sure you're breathing. Start to really connect with your breath, whether that's ujjayi, with your mouth closed, in through your nose, out through your nose, or a deeper breath in through your nose and out through your mouth. Keep your shoulders away from your ears. You can close your eyes or keep your focus very soft. Once you're back up to center, roll your shoulders back up and down, and go into an easy side bend. Right hand out front, left hand comes over the top. Peek up underneath that arm, chest is open. Starting to open up the side body, switch over to the other side, big rainbow up and over. And one more each side. Reach up as high as you can before you lean to the side. Breathing that whole time. Come back to center. We're gonna do a seated cat-cow today. So on the inhale, chest comes up, gaze goes up, back arches slightly. And exhale, round everything in, chin towards the chest. Hands can grip your knees for a little support. Inhale brings you back up. Tiny arch. Exhale brings you down. One more like this. Inhale up. And exhale, round. And then come on over to your hands and knees. I'm gonna do a wrist stretch because we will be going through some flows today. To start, all 10 fingers glued down to the mat. Fingertips facing forward. Just gonna do a little rock, a little forward, a little back to start. Just to get that mindfulness, pressing down through all 10 fingers. Change it to side to side. It's a slight motion, nothing too big. And then we'll flip those palms over, fingers face you. Once again, start forward and back. And side to side. Last, flip them over on top, just one at a time this time. Don't put too much pressure on your wrist and glue down your thumb and your pinky finger. Be a little side to side, but only one wrist is flipped. And then flip-flop it. Other one turns over. Front and back to start. Just to feel a nice stretch, not a strain. And lastly, fingers face each other. We'll go side to side. Nice and easy. And then fingers fingers face forward. Find that perfect tabletop position. Knees are lined up right underneath your hips. Wrists are right underneath your shoulders. We're going to go into a bird dog. Right arm lifts forward, thumb is towards the sky. Left leg lifts back. This first one we're just going to hold. Focus on that lengthening. Make your body as long as you can through that straight arm and straight leg. Try to square the hips towards the floor. Tighten through your core. Pull your belly button in through your back. And your gaze is slightly down, but it's a little slightly in front of you. And relax it. Switch over other side. Left arm lifts first, thumb towards the sky. Right leg lifts back, toes towards the floor. Hips are square, pressing firmly through your whole right hand. Just holding and breathing. And release it, bring it down. We're gonna do a shoulder stretch before we get moving today. Reach your left arm up, open your chest, loop it underneath. And if it works for you, bring your shoulder down to the ground. If it's too much, keep it up. You'll still feel the stretch. Or if you have a pillow or anything nearby to put underneath your shoulder, that sometimes helps as well. So your supporting arm, your right hand here, can stay supporting or it can reach out. Still finding that breath. If your hand extended out, bring it back in. Press right back up to table. Reach your right hand high. Loop it through. Once again, if you can get your shoulders to the mat, use it. If not, keep it out. An option to extend the other arm. Straight back up. Hips stay right where they are. So hips right over the knees. We're going to go into puppy pose. So it's like a child's pose, but the hips are lifted. So reach your hands out. It's a huge chest opener, especially if you're nursing or feeding a baby all day. You're hunched over. This will really open through your shoulders. Move your chin towards the mat. Maybe it touches, maybe it doesn't. Make sure those hips stay high. And then wiggle it back to tabletop one more time. Do a variation of that puppy pose. This time reach your right arm out to a diagonal. Left arm's gonna bend. And we're just gonna open up that one shoulder. So hips are still high. Breath is still relaxed and calm. Come right back up, and other side, which the opposite arm up. And then press back up, hands plant down, knees lift up, lead in downward facing dog. First down dog of the day, plant your feet so they're about hip distance. Shoulders are going to be a little bit wider than hip or shoulder distance to start, and press your hips back. So you're in an upside down letter V with your body. Tailbone's towards the sky. Gaze is back towards your feet and let your head hang heavy. We're going to start to deepen these breaths. And on your next inhale, gaze forward towards your hands and ever so slowly and softly walk those feet, tiptoe, 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 your feet up to meet your hands. Bend your knees as much as you need to. You'll be at the top of your mat, a pretty generous knee bend, especially if your hamstrings are tight. Let your head hang heavy. And then especially for this first one, roll it up extra slow. Use your hands on your thighs. Press it up. Roll your shoulders back and down. And we'll meet in mountain pose at the top of your mat. We're going to start with our feet wide. If you've been practicing and it feels good to start with your feet together, you can start with your feet together. But I'm going to start with my feet hip distance today. We'll give you a little bit more support. And especially if you're just coming back after having a baby, this is exactly what we need in our hips. So the feet are pretty wide. Palms turn out, facing forward. I'm going to start with a half sun salutation. So inhale up. Arms can meet at the top. Exhale, forward fold. Hands can come through heart center or swan dive down. Inhale, halfway lift. Hands can come to your shins or to the floor if you have that flexibility. And then nice flat back all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. And then down by your side. Two more just like that. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale all the way up, nice and strong to the top. Hands through heart center. Last time through. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. Bending your knees if you need to. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale brings you all the way up. Hands to heart center. Moving on this time, we're going to inhale up. Exhale, fold. Step your right foot back. Knees come onto the mat and both hands come to the center in the inside foot. You might need to wiggle your left foot towards the outside of your mat a little bit. A real big hip opener here. Chest is going to stay up on this one. If this is too much to have your hands on the mat, you can always walk them back up onto your leg. Or if you have yoga blocks, this is a great spot to use them as well. So find yourself into this lizard pose. Many of us new mamas sit a lot of the day, and this is a great stretch to do at the end of the day to open up your hip flexors after sitting. I'm going to transition into half splits. Move your hands back. I'm going to straighten out your front leg, toes towards the ceiling, and just think your heart towards your knee. Your head doesn't need to go anywhere near your knee. Think more your heart towards your knee. From here, we're going to go into a modified side plank. So you're going to take that right leg and turn it this way. Bring that left leg long. Palm flat. Hand can stay on your hip if you're balanced, if you're feeling a little bit wobbly, or reach it up towards the sky. If you're ready for a full side plank, I welcome you there. It's a great modification to get started. Let's reach it up and over. Straight back out. Turn it around. Bring it right back to tabletop and then press it to downward facing dog. Big inhale here. Big exhale. Next inhale, gaze forward. Little steps to the top of your mat, bending your knees as much as you need to. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale brings you all the way up to stand, hands at heart center. Going through the other side. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. Step your left foot back. Knee comes down. Hands can come up onto your thigh or in the middle into that lizard pose. Wiggle your right foot a little bit towards the edge of your mat. And if you need a little bit more, you can always come down into blocks or a cushion or your forearms. My flexibility is not there, so I'll stay on my hands. Breathing here, sending that left hip forward. Now inching it back to a half split. Straighten out that front leg, right toes towards the sky. Turn slightly towards that right leg and then think heart to your knee. Make sure you're breathing. Moving into that side plank, put more weight in your left leg. Turn that foot back, put your right foot out to the side. Palm is down, straight line up towards the sky, or keep your hand on your hip. Gaze can be up, can be down if you're feeling a little wobbly. And then reach it up and over. Really strong line from those fingertips all the way down to your toes. Bring your hand back up and then down to the mat, back to table, and then exhale back to downward facing dog. Press those heels towards the ground. They don't have to necessarily touch. Hips go high to the sky. Next inhale, look forward, and then walk it back up. Top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Long, strong spine. Exhale, fold. Inhale, brings you all the way up. Reach as high as you can. Hands to heart center. And then down by your side. Now, if you'd like to challenge yourself a little bit and wiggle your feet together, toes touch, a little space behind your heels. We'll move on to our next sun salutation. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Step your right foot back this time. We're going to find our way into a crescent lunge. So just stay on your toes. Walk your hands up to your knee. Find your balance. You find yourself to be tilting all over the place, find yourself near a wall, so it gives you a little bit of help. Once again, we're on our back foot. We're not in warrior one, so we're on our back toe, all of our foot. And then when you're ready, if you become ready, hands come up. Deep bend through your front leg. Relax your shoulders. Gaze can be straight ahead. If you want a little more of a challenge, gaze up towards those hands. Bring your shoulders out, around, and down. A little stroke opening. Hands come down to the mat. Step back to plank, or knees plank. I'm going to hold here. Hold and breathe. Hold and breathe. One more. Then back to downward facing dog. You can be a little bit closer or keep in a wide stance. Little big breaths here. And then next inhale, hinge your right foot forward into that crescent. Legs come up. Ball your back foot. When you're ready, if you become ready, you can just come straight up. Tuck your tailbone under and deep end through your front leg. Big inhale, and then longer exhale. And then arms come up and open. Big chest opening. Hands come down, this time step up to the front. Inhale, halfway up. And exhale, fold. Inhale, bring you all the way back up. Hands to heart center. And down the other side. Roll your shoulders up, back, down. And then inhale, straight up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Step your right foot back. So we're going to come into a warrior two. Use your leg as much as you need to. Your back foot is at an angle, it's at a 45 degree angle. Your front foot, toes are pointing forward, arms come straight out, and then gaze over that middle finger. So you want to be able to look down, peek down and see if you can see your first two toes. You can see your big toe and your second toe. If you can't, your knee is probably collapsing in, open up that thigh. Even if you have to come up a little bit, protect your knee. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, up and over, reverse your warrior. Gaze comes up. Light hand, you can lightly touch that back leg for some support. And then wiggle those hands down to the mat. Step it back to plank or modify the plank. And then breathe for three. Always option to drop your knees. Just make sure if you drop your knees, those hips stay close to the floor. They're not backwards here. One, send it back to downward facing dog. Three breaths, rest those hips as high as they'll go. Let's go with your right leg forward. Get in there however you need to. If you need to pull help it, bring it up, wiggle it up, step it up. It doesn't need to be graceful. Inhale it up, coming straight up. Warrior to the other side. Check in with your feet. So the front toes are pointing directly forward. Back toes at a 45 degree angle. Arms are up. Right at shoulder height. Try to avoid this. Rest them down. Hands over your middle finger. Hold and breathe. Sink a little bit more. Take a quick little peek. Can you see your big toe, your second toe? If not, move that thigh out. Inhale forward, exhale back, pull your hands down, step back to plank, or that modified plank, squeeze and breathe, flex your toes, you have a long straight line from your shoulders to your heels. Last one here, send it back. Your next inhale, bring it forward. Tiptoe to the top of your mat. And this time, just roll it up nice and slow. I'm gonna find a wide stance. So a huge step out. If you're on a yoga mat, line up the edges of your feet with that yoga mat. So feet aren't turned out or turned in. They're parallel. Big inhale up. Hands come to heart center. Gonna tilt forward with a real flat back. So press your thumbs into your sternum. Flat back, flat back, flat back, flat back, as long as you can go. Then hands come to the mat. And you can keep it flat, just for one, two, three. Let it round and fold. Now shift a little bit of weight into your toes. And then try to squeeze the yoga mat together so much so that you can perform or make a wrinkle in it. You're not going to be able to because all your weight is on that mat, but you're pulling in, so you're really activating your inner thighs. Let your head be heavy. Stay standing even when you're up here in this twist. knee sit, hips back down, right hand lands right in front of your face, left hand reaches up just to the hip, make sure those hips are nice and level towards the floor. Maybe open your shoulder just a little bit, reaching up if it's there. If you get there and you change your mind, just come back. Somehow get out of that stance, and then find yourself onto your left foot. Left foot plants, right foot can start on the mat, toe here, toe on your calf, or bring it all the way up to your inner thigh. Wherever you find the balance for today, you're gonna find yourself in a tree pose. Hands come to heart center. If this feels good, grow your branches all the way up. If it feels really good, close your eyes. Here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release it, coming in other side. Plant that right foot strong down to the floor. All 5 toes. Start with toes on the floor. Then maybe move it up to your calf. If you're feeling a challenge today, move it up to your inner thigh. Just avoid your knee. So it's either below your knee or above your knee, not on your knee. Hands come to heart center to start. Make sure that knee is open up to the side. Then if you're ready, grow your tree. All the way up. Shoulders stay relaxed. Arms are more in a Y in this position, not all the way to your ears. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Relax it down. Have a seat on your mat. You're going to find yourself into a cow face pose. Left leg's going to tuck under first. Right leg's going to come on top. Find your way onto both sits bones. And then your right arm's going to come up top. Left arm is going to come meet it. This is great if you can't touch your hands. This is a great space for a towel, or a band, or use your shirt to wiggle them close. Find that tall posture. Press your head into that right arm. Try to hook your fingers. And if it feels okay, tilt forward just a little bit. Lean forward, think heart towards your knees. Keeping both sits bones still on the floor. Release your arms, release your legs, and switch over to the other side. Right leg tucks under, left leg's on top. Left arm reaches up and over. You can press on the elbow to give it a little bit of advantage to start. Right arm reaches back, around and up. Try and move those fingers as close as you can. One side is usually better than the other. My first side is definitely a little bit more flexible. If you're ready for that lean and you have your fingers and you want a little bit more, tilt forward. This side's a little bit of a struggle for me, so I'm gonna keep my spine long. And just work on the shoulder opening in that tall posture. Last inhale, and release it. Relax your shoulders, shake them out. Legs come straight out in front. Seated forward fold, toes come towards the sky. Find the length first. We're gonna keep our arms down today. Find the length, inhale up. Exhale, tilt forward with a flat back. See how far you can go with a flat back. Maybe you can only touch your thighs. Maybe you can get your calves. I can only reach my toes because I have long arms, not because I'm flexible. Move your heart towards your knees. And then once you feel that point, you really can't go anymore, I really can't go without bending, rounding my back, then I can round down. Reach the ground, move your heels. Try not to have your toes turn out. Keep them right up towards the ceiling. Last inhale. Exhale, legs stay where they are. Arms reach back this time. Try to keep them on your yoga mat. Maybe pinkies move a little bit closer together depending on how your chest and your shoulders are feeling today. And we're gonna inhale up. Exhale, sink into the stretch. Broaden through your chest. Eye gaze can be towards the ceiling. Unless it really feels good for you to hang your head backwards, I avoid it in this posture. Keep your legs nice and active. Last inhale. And then wiggle it out. And find yourself into a straddle, whatever that means for you. Legs come out wide. I'm going to start with a similar move that we did in the beginning with that side body stretch. Right arm's going to come down, left arm's going to come up. I'm going to reach over the top. And maybe that means just here, which is fine. Both toes are facing towards the ceiling. Knees are facing towards the ceiling, so we don't want everything collapsing in. As you lift up and over, maybe you can reach all the way to your toe, but I don't want you to sacrifice your posture to do it. So this doesn't matter. This doesn't count. There's no extra credit for reaching your toe today. Maybe a different day, but not today. So keep your chest open, and then if you have that flexibility to reach your toe, fantastic. I'm not quite there on this side today. And yes, every day can be completely different. So just feeling that long side body stretch. Then coming right back up to center, going right into the other side. Other side drops, and you might feel very different on the other side. Make sure your chest is open, toes are towards the ceiling. Coming right back up. One short one right to the middle. If you know you're super bending and you can get to the floor, you're welcome to grab your toes for this one. I'm not in that camp, so I'm going to put my forearms down and find a flat back. And then reach my hands out as far as I can to find the inner thigh stretch. Notice my toes are still facing the ceiling. My legs are active, even though this is a stretch. Walk your fingers out as far as you can. And then I'll challenge you to let your head hang because it pulls you through a little bit more. Slowly walk those hands in, wiggle those feet, those legs back together. And go ahead and lay down right on your mat. However that is for you, maybe you have to put out on your side and roll it back, or you can add a little bit of core if you'd like it, and slowly come down, depending on where you are, and find yourself into a happy baby. The knees come wide, hands can be on the outside of your feet or the outside of your thighs. Your upper body's relaxed, so don't have your head up here. It's time for it to rest. Let it go down. Let it release. Pull your knees towards the floor. Go ahead and release it. Pull your knees into your chest. Give your lower back a little love, rock side to side. And the next time your knees drop to the left, let them drop all the way to the left. All the way down. Right arm reaches out. Gaze can go out towards your right hand. Left hand can help here. Press your right leg down. Find yourself into a spinal twist. Breath should be returning to normal, returning to ease. Knees come up through center, and then just scoot your hips and slide your knees over to the right. Eye gaze to the left, try to keep your left shoulder on the floor. If you want a little bit more, you can fall on this left side. And then last time, back up to center. Give everything a squeeze. Everything comes in tight. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And then let it go. Extend your arms, extend your legs. Palms face the ceiling. Feet can be apart, toes can splay to the side. And if it's comfortable and you're in a space that you can, close your eyes. And I know it's tempting to just shut it off and skip this part. But let your body reap the benefits of your practice. We'll be here less than a minute. Take the time for you today. Let your heart rate come down. Let your mind be calm. Did you feel your heels press into the mat? Feel the weight of your hips. The pressure of your shoulders. The backs of your hands pressing gently on the floor underneath you. Thank yourself for taking the time today for you. Because when you take the time for you, you're a better everything. You're a better you, you're a better mom, you're a better spouse, you're a better partner. Thank you for taking the time for you today. On your next inhale, bring your hands over your head. And then a big good morning stretch. Wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. And then roll onto your favorite side. Eyes can stay closed if you feel comfortable. Take a pause on that side just for a moment. And then bring it up to a comfortable seat. Eyes can still remain closed. How we started practice. On your next inhale, sweep those arms out and all the way up. Hands come to heart center. And then bring your thumbs to your third eye, which is the space between your eyebrows. Namaste. Nice work, beautiful mamas. Did a great job today. That's our big intro class. Join me again soon by hitting that subscribe button. I post videos every Sunday on the yoga and strength. Have a great day.